Hello, my name is William Heppel, and I'm going to tell you about all the footballers who went to war. In 1914, World War I broke out between Germany and England. The Sunderland stars of the Great War era were heroes of the football field and the battlefield. Charlie Buchan, Lee Rose, Harry Lowe, Albert Milton, Bert Hobson, Bob Young and Thomas Rawlinson all collected a haul of medals and trophies as players. But when their footballing careers were cut short by the outbreak of the First World War on August 4th, 1914, they showed just as much fighting spirit off the pitch as on it. The outbreak of the war saw thousands of Wearsiders sign up to fight, but Sunderland's star footballers were all under contract to stay till the end of the season. Most continued to play with great reluctance, and once the season was over, service in the Army, Royal Navy and munitions factories followed for the majority of men. Welsh international Lee Richmond Roos was Sunderland's first choice of goalkeeper from 1908 until 1910, when he broke his wrist in a match. Tragically, on October 7th, 1916, he lost his life during an attack on German trenches at Greed Court, last seen running towards the enemy at full speed firing his gun. Charlie Buchan, hailed as one of Sunderland's all-time greats, was a hero both on and off the football pitch. Despite his devotion to football, however, he was determined to fight when war broke out. Indeed, the end of the 1914-15 season couldn't come soon enough for Charlie. Charlie survived the Somme, Cambrai and Passchendaele without a scratch, winning a military medal for his actions during the Battle of Bossain in Belgium. Charlie, who was capped for England 6 times, died in June 1960, aged 68. He is still Sunderland's record league scorer with 209 goals. Albert Milton, bought by Sunderland in 1908, joined Royal Field Artillery as a bombardier, killed in action at Passchendaele on October 11, 1917. Harry Ness played for Sunderland and Barnsley, a corporal in the Royal Engineers. He was awarded the Victory and British Star. George Anderson played for Sunderland and Aberdeen, served with the Royal Marine Light Infantry. Sammy Hartnell, reserve centre forward, served as a gunner with the Royal Garrison Artillery and killed in action in France on August 8, 1918. Tommy Thompson and Tom Wilson, 1914-15 Sunderland reserves, both served in the Cyclist Corps. Bert Hobson, signed by Sunderland in 1912, played for Wolves and Stoke during the war, but also won a military medal for bravery with Northumberland Fusiliers. Henry Martin won the Football League title with Sunderland in 1913, served in the Army during the Great War and later managed Mansfield Town. Thomas Sowerby Rawlinson, keeper from 1904 to 1905, served as a captain in the Yorkshire Hussars, won a military cross, killed in action on September 15th, 1916. Jimmy Seed, 1914-15 Sunderland reserve team, joined the Cyclist Corps, gassed in the last month of the war, and only played once for Sunderland in 1919 on his return. Bob Young played for Sunderland and coached Norwich City. He won a military medal for his bravery at Cambrin in 1916 during the Battle of Somme, wounded in action.
Here I stand, a free person, still be able to watch Sunderland play 100 years after the war.
As I'm making this video, I feel a bit happy because how all the soldiers and football players give their lives to just keep us alive today and freedom. It's 100 years after the war and like so much has changed, and it's actually like, it's really, yeah, you'll never forget, because what they done was so brave, just to risk their lives for us. When I think about war, it's just like, instead of going straight to war, we should like talk about things first, and we shouldn't just go straight to fighting, and I think war should stop. When so many people go to war and like so many die, loads of families just lose loads of family members. My final words are, nobody ever wins a war because we all end up losing.
What is